Hello students, welcome to the chapter Relations and Functions. Now, especially we shall discuss only about relations. Let us take up some problems based on relations as well as the previous concept, that is nothing but cross product. So this is the first question. If A is equal to A comma B comma C, B is equal to B comma C comma D, and C is equal to A comma D comma C, then A minus B cross B intersection C is equal to. These are the four given options. This question has come in CET 2006. The correct answer is option A. Why is that? We'll see. A minus B. What do you mean by A minus B? Elements which are in A but not in B. That is the meaning of A minus B. That is equal to A. And B intersection C. What do you mean by intersection? It is nothing but common elements. So what is common between B and C? It is nothing but C comma D. Therefore, A minus B cross B intersection C. How do you find the cross product? By taking the first element from the first set and the second element from the second set. So that is nothing but A comma C and A comma D. That is why option A is the correct answer. Let us go for the next question. If set A has P elements, B has Q elements, then the number of elements in A cross B is. These are the four given options here. Now, this question has come in CET 2000. Which is the correct answer? Correct answer is option C. Why is that? We know that N of A cross B is nothing but N of A into N of B. Therefore, here what I want is N of A cross B that is equal to N of A, which is equal to P, and N of B that is equal to Q. Therefore, the answer is PQ. Let me go for the next example. Let us consider this example. A is equal to A comma B and B is equal to Ali, Bharat and Anil. Let us define a relation from a non-empty set A to a non-empty set B. To do this, we should link pairs of objects from the two sets. That is, we need to write the cross product. Which, what is that cross product? A cross B. So let me write that. A Ali, A Bharat, A Anil. B Ali, B Bharat and B Anil. Now, the process of linking the elements is complete. The relation is defined as is the first letter of the name. That means I am relating X to Y. When I am relating X to Y, if and only if X is the first letter of the name Y. So, if suppose I impose this condition and I select some of the pairs from this, then what are the pairs that I can collect? Can you tell me? I can take A comma Ali because A is the first letter of the name Ali. And A Bharat I can't take because A is not the first letter of the name Bharat. A Anil I can take. B Ali I can't. B Bharat, yes, I can take. B Anil I can't. This subset of the cross product A cross B is called as relation from A to B. Now, what is the domain of the relation? Now, we have the relation here with us. What do you mean by domain? The domain of R means it is a set of all first elements of the ordered pairs in R. Don't look at this A cross B. Don't collect the pairs from A cross B. Look at the pairs which are in the relation and collect the first elements. So, which are the first elements that I can take? A I can take and I can take B. So, this is the domain of the relation. Now, what do you mean by range of the relation? If suppose I take up the same relation, now what you do is collect all the second elements of the ordered pairs which are in the relation, not in the cross product. So, if I do that, I can collect Ali, I can collect Anil and I can collect Bharat. So, Ali, Anil, Bharat is the range of the relation. What is the codomain of the relation? The codomain is nothing but the entire second set. Entire second set you take, that is called as codomain. It is nothing but Ali, Anil and Bharat. Let me now take up a remark. Let A be a non-void set, non-empty set. Then any relation from A to itself, that is subset of A cross A, is also called as a relation on A. Now, this is what a student should and must remember. Now, the first one, If A and B are two sets with n of A is equal to m and n of B is equal to n, then the number of elements in A cross B is equal to mn. The first thing to be remembered. The number of subsets of A cross B is equal to 2 to the power mn. And I have told you that any subset of cross product is always a relation. So number of relations that we can define from A to B is nothing but 2 to the power mn. Now it is very important to remember these points. Let us take up some problems. If a set A has n elements, then the number of relations on A is, these are the four given options. The question which has come in Comet K 2008. Let us solve this particular question. Any subset of A cross A is always called as what? A relation. Relation from A to A, or I can say that it is a relation on A. N of A is how much here? N. So what is the number of elements in the cross product A cross A? It is nothing but n square. So number of relations is nothing but 2 to the power n square. Why? Because I said any subset of the cross product is always a relation. That is why option D is the correct answer.